President Biden will be aware of that when he lands tomorrow. Just going back to what you were saying, do you think he will apply the pressure? I mean, they've backed Israel to the hilt so far, but do you think he will apply the pressure to have a ceasefire?
Well, I think it's very telling that your guest from the Palestinian group, they're upset that Joe Biden wants to meet in Jordan, which is a neutral country in this fight. So I don't understand, you know, why is that a problem? So you want to put the thumb on the scale to have him go to Ramallah, why not have him in Jordan when that is more of a neutral place? So he's wanting to have a biased situation here from the beginning.
I think the point he was making, though, that he's going to Jerusalem, which is not a neutral place, and therefore he should come to Ramallah, which is also not a neutral place.
Well, he also completely ignored the fact he said genocide, he said ethnic cleansing. This was the largest slaughter of Jews since the Holocaust.
Okay.
Now, there are many in the Arab world who want to deny that the Holocaust happened, yeah. But that was the mass slaughter and the mass ethnic cleansing that cannot be ignored.
I'm not denying that, and I appreciate it, and I'm absolutely sympathetic to both sides here, but I just want to get an impression from you about President Biden and whether he's going to call for that ceasefire tomorrow. Is that where the American public is right now, and is that what he's coming to do?
Well, I think the reason he's going to Jerusalem is because there was an ethnic cleansing, the largest since the Holocaust. And so that is wholly appropriate for, on behalf of the American people, to go there and express the sympathies that we will not ignore, that this is the revised Holocaust. And you know what? Shin Bet, the head of, the head of Shin Bet, the Israeli security forces, he took public acknowledgement of the failures on the part of the Israeli government, and it was an utter failure. I do place the failure here on the feet of Joe Biden as well, in terms of, you know, he's playing football with Iran. Meanwhile, Iran is funding and training.
He's just sent two strike groups to the region. There are 2,000 Marines on standby.
It's too little, too late. I'm afraid that is classic Joe Biden, reactionary. Put American blood, American, and that's one thing I do agree with your Palestinian guest. I don't want American troops there. I don't. I agree with him on that respect. But that is Joe Biden's MO when it comes to foreign policy. Always late. Always stumbling instead of being a leader. And so I think he bears some responsibility for it. And look, he is my president. I wish him the best. I do wish for for a certain removal of Hamas. Hamas is a cancer on the world, is a cancer on the Muslim people as well. Muslim people are the ones who suffer the most when you're talking about radical Islamic ideology. Again, that is the founding charter of Hamas, is to call for jihad. Jihad kills innocent Muslims are the biggest victim when it comes to this.